Hey everyone, life is expensive nowadays, with a box of 6 chicken nuggets costing almost £5, and some pet food shooting up by almost 60% in a single year. So when building a new PC, it can be tempting to cut down on costs by going with used computer parts. But there's some components that you should never buy secondhand, apparently. Now, I should caution that some of the parts that I mention in this video might seem a little bit controversial, but I'll explain my thoughts as I go through this video. The first bit of hardware that you should never buy secondhand is storage. Everyone agrees on that. YouTube videos say to avoid it, the comments under the videos say to avoid it, Reddit says it, and in general, this is great advice. But there are actually one or two cases when new storage is actually fine to buy. So let's break this down. The reason that people say to avoid storage is that it can be quite hard to actually know whether a hard drive or solid state drive is actually still healthy or not. Yes, you can go into the drive and check the smart data for that drive because this shows loads of useful stats like the power on hours and how much the disk has been written to. But in some cases, smart data can actually be reset, a bit like how cars can have their mileage rolled back to a lower number and then sold by an unscrupulous seller. Now, this isn't easy to do, and I doubt that many eBay sellers would go through the effort of resetting the smart data just for a $20 drive, but it's still good to know. Also, some people report general stability issues with certain types of drives. For example, people who buy and sell lots of drives say that WD drives fail more than other types of drives. Plus, certain drives from Dell and HPE have been known to randomly die after running for 40,000 hours, known as the 40K bug, which is basically 4 to 5 years of usage, which isn't much if they're running in a server 24/7. I guess my point here is it's hard to actually know whether a secondhand drive you plan on buying will be a dud or not. After all, it's unlikely the sellers are going to allow you to perform loads of detailed tests on the drive before buying it. Now, they might include a diagnostic screenshot on the listing page, but a simple image can easily be faked or photoshopped, so it's not always worth relying on that either. The only time that I would personally buy a secondhand drive is enterprise SAS drives. These are great for adding loads of extra storage capacity to a server or computer on a budget, and the drives often have much better reliability than consumer gear. The second part that I wouldn't personally buy used is a motherboard. Now, some people disagree with me here and they say that it's fine to buy these secondhand, but motherboards are fairly complex bits of hardware because they just do so much. So any small defect can result in a bunch of weird temperamental faults. I had a computer 5 or 6 years ago that would randomly lock up a few times a week, especially after booting up, and after loads and loads of debugging, I tracked it back to a bad motherboard. It certainly isn't easy to hunt down these motherboard faults though. Plus, it's kind of difficult to prove that a motherboard is faulty. A bad RAM stick or graphics card is easy to track down because there's loads of different stress testing tools out there for you to test them on. For example, if a single RAM stick crashes during memtest 86, you've clearly got a bad stick of RAM. But a faulty motherboard? No dice. It's much harder to actually track this down. Also, a motherboard can be more susceptible to physical damage during a PC install than other parts. For example, the screwdriver scratching through a trace can completely brick the motherboard. So I'm personally quite wary about buying secondhand motherboard parts unless I know the person I'm buying it from or it's an open box return from a reputable retailer. But I do know that some people freely buy used motherboards though. If this is you, then please let us know why down in the comments, because maybe I'm just missing something. The third computer component that I personally think you should never buy secondhand is the power supply unit, and this is a crucial point. The PSU is such an important component because it literally sucks electricity from the wall, and yes, I know that sucks isn't the right term, but it distributes that power to the rest of your computer. A bad PSU can actually destroy other parts of your computer in the worst case. When you buy it secondhand, you don't actually know what conditions the PSU has been running under. Maybe it was run in an overpowered rig 24/7. Maybe it ran in a humid area like a garage or shed for a few years straight. You just don't know when you can't really open the PSU to find it out. So if you don't know the seller, I wouldn't risk it. But conversely, if your friend is selling a PSU and they only use it for occasional gaming for a year or so, then it's likely to be fine. Equally, some power supply companies actually sell refurbished PSUs on the website, and I touch on this in another video if you wanted to check that out, but my home lab NAS actually has a refurbished Corsair PSU in it, and I've had no problems with that, despite it running 24/7 for many months so far. So in general, used PSUs are a big no-no unless you know and trust the seller. But really, you could buy a quality PSU for under £50 or $50 that can run up to mid-range PSUs without any issue, so there's kind of a risk-reward question here. Why take the chance on a used PSU when you can just buy a brand new one for such a small price? Unless you get a really, really good deal on a used one, I probably wouldn't chance it. Next up, graphics cards. This is a difficult one because I've always kind of thought, oh, many old GPUs have been used in mining rigs, so they aren't good to buy used. And yes, Some sales listings are honest and openly declare they've been used for mining, and then you can make an informed decision. But many people lie too. They say that the GPU's only been used for light gaming, but it's actually been toiling away in a mining rig for many years. So should we always avoid GPUs? Well, this is actually a difficult one, because Linus Tech Tips done a really awesome video where they went out and purchased 19 old mining GPUs, and only one of them was faulty. The rest actually worked as expected. As a result, what I'd recommend with GPUs is that you should only buy used GPUs if the seller is trustworthy. And ideally, you should only buy if there's some way of actually testing the graphics card after receiving it, and then you have the ability to return it for a full refund if it's faulty. After all, you can run FurMark on the GPU and then return it if artifacts appear, for example. But it also comes down to price. There's no point in taking a risk if you're only getting a 5 or 10% discount. But sometimes a used GPU can be had at a big discount over the full retail price, which is then worth considering for sure. The fifth component I personally would never buy used are water cooling parts. Yes, these can get surprisingly expensive, so why wouldn't you save money here, right? Well, I always worry about leaks with water cooling, of course. And whether it's a custom block or an all-in-one cooler, I wouldn't fully trust that the other seller has treated the product with the care that it requires for water cooling to actually prevent leaks. It's kind of a free of the unknown type situation for me. Plus, it's not just the leaks are a risk. If the pump is broken or degraded, then your GPU or CPU could be running at way higher temperatures than it actually should be. Some people also say that you should avoid used CPUs because the pins can be bent on them, and in some cases, fake CPUs are actually being sold by dodgy sellers who literally change the CPU model number etchings on the front of the processor, which is really concerning. Gamers Nexus published a really great video on this a couple of years ago. For me personally though, this just depends on where I'm buying a used CPU from. If it's from a reputable hardware retailer, then I probably would trust it, but a random seller on eBay or on AliExpress, not so much. And this goes back to a common theme that I've mentioned throughout this video, who the seller actually is. I personally was happy to buy a used, well, refurbished PSU because it came directly from Corsair with a warranty, and so I trusted that. Equally, I'd happily purchase a used CPU, motherboard, and GPU as long as I trusted the seller. But I would not buy from a random used hardware source because the risk is just too high for me, especially considering that sometimes the used price isn't actually all that much less than the brand new retail price, particularly if you're happy to wait for sales like Black Friday events to actually come up. That's my take on it anyway, but what about you? Which PC parts are you happy to buy secondhand, and which would you always avoid? Please let me know down in the comments, especially if you've ever bought used storage. I'd be really interested to know your thoughts there and how it worked out for you. Building computers generally isn't always cheap or easy, and I used to find the wiring at the components for the PSU was one of the hardest bits, especially when it comes to the bulky motherboard cable and also powering the expensive graphics card. You really don't want to make a mistake there. That's why I've created a full guide for how to connect up all of the PSU cables, and it's updated for the latest ATX 3.0 and 3.1 standards. It runs through all of the different cables and what to do with each of them, and also cover the best practices for actually powering your graphics card. Then you can check my video out here somewhere. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.